ओके, तो वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल। तो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन द फील्ड ऑफ बायोपेस्टिसाइड अबाउट ट्राइकोग्रामा। इन अर्लियर लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट बायो कंट्रोल एजेंट्स यूजिंग बैक्टीरिया, फंजाई, वायरस, सम बॉटनिकल्स, स्पेशली अबाउट सोडोमोनास, अबाउट ट्राइकोडर्मा। सो देयर इंपॉर्टेंस, हाउ वी कैन डू देयर मास मल्टीप्लीकेशन, हाउ वी कैन अप्लाई इन द फील्ड, वॉट आर देयर एडवांटेजेस, वॉट आर देयर डिसएडवांटेजेस। देन वी कम टू वन ऑफ द लास्ट एजेंट दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ट्राइकोग्रामा। ट्राइकोग्रामा बिलोंग्स टू कैटेगरी पैरासिटॉइड्स। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो वॉट आर पैरासिटॉइड्स। तो ट्राइकोग्रामा बिलोंग्स टू पैरासिटॉइड एंड दिस टॉपिक यू विल स्टडी हाउ दे आर यूज इन द एज ए पेस्ट कंट्रोल। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो वॉट इज पैरासिटॉइड। पैरासिटॉइड एज आई टोल्ड यू दे आर स्मॉल ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर फाउंड इन साइड द पैरासाइट्स। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी कैन से दैट पैरासिटॉइड वेस्ट ऑफ जीनस ट्राइकोग्रामा इट बिलोंग्स टू ऑर्डर हिम्नोप्टेरा एंड फैमिली बिलोंग्स टू ट्राइकोग्रामिडी। फ्रॉम हेयर दिस वर्ड कम्स ट्राइकोग्रामा। ओके, दिस पैरासिटॉइड वेस ऑफ जीनस ट्राइकोग्रामा इट इंक्लूड्स वेरियस स्पीसीज दैट आर फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज एज बायो कंट्रोल एजेंट्स थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड। ओके, सो ट्राइकोग्रामा इज अ काइंड ऑफ पैरासिटॉइड्स बिलोंग्स टू ऑर्डर हिम्नोप्टेरा एंड फैमिली ट्राइकोग्रामेटिडी विच इंक्लूड्स सेवरल स्पीसीज दैट आर फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज एज बायो कंट्रोल एजेंट्स वर्ल्ड वाइड। बेसिकली ट्राइकोग्रामा आर एग पैरासिटॉइड्स विच ले देयर एग्स इन साइड द एग्स ऑफ इंसेक्ट पेस्ट। ओके, ट्राइकोग्रामा आर एग पैरासिटॉइड्स विच ले देयर एग्स इन साइड द एग्स ऑफ इंसेक्ट पेस्ट। ओके, इट मीन्स दैट बेसिकली दे आर मेनली एग लिविंग क्रिएचर्स। ओके, इट मीन्स दे देमसेल्व्स ले द एग्स इन साइड द एग्स ऑफ द इंसेक्ट्स। दैट इज द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ पैरासिटॉइड्स। ओके, देन कम द होस्ट ऑफ द पैरासिटाइट आर द एग्स ऑफ शुगर केन बोरर्स, कटवर्म्स, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज एग्रोटस स्पीसीज, कॉटन बॉल वर्म्स एंड मेज स्टेम बोरर Kylo pertulus. So these are the main insects in which these trichogramma lay their eggs. Okay. So what are these insect pests? They are sugarcane borers, cutworms, cotton boll worms, and maize stem borer. However, in 1960 to 1970s, almost about 7 lakh hectare of Chinese corn fields were treated with trichogramma totally. The farmers have shown keen attention and attraction for rearing and raising of trichogramma. Okay, this the use, multiplication and rearing of trichogramma is little bit tedious. So the concept should be very, very clear. Okay, so what I told, the trichogramma release their eggs inside the eggs of the sugarcane borers, cutworms, cotton boll worms, meristem borer, and these are called as Kylo pertulus. In 1960-1970, about 7 lakh hectare of Chinese cornfields were treated with trichogramma totally. Okay, so farmers were involved in rearing and releasing of trichogramma. Okay, farmers were involved in rearing and releasing of trichogramma. So this trichogramma as the egg parasitoid has gained lot of attention. Okay, so this trichogramma as the egg parasitoids has gained lot of attention. Then we reach next point is how we can do the rearing of this trichogramma. We can see this is the small eggs of parasitoids. Now we can see how we can do the rearing of trichogramma species. So first of all, what we have to do, we have to go for the collection of trichogramma from field as the founder population. We should allow their propagation and their conservation. The first step in the rearing is कलेक्शन ऑफ ट्राइकोग्रामा फ्रॉम फील्ड एज फाउंडर पॉपुलेशन. ओके देन दे शुड बी अलाउड फॉर देयर प्रॉपर प्रोपोगेशन एंड कंजर्वेशन. देन सेलेक्शन ऑफ द होस्ट एग्स एंड देयर स्टोरेज शुड बी डन. एंड आई टोल्ड यू विच आर द होस्ट एग्स, स्टेम बोरर, मेज बोरर, शुगर केन बोरर. सो वी शुड हैव द प्रिवेंटिव मेजर फॉर सेलेक्शन ऑफ द होस्ट एग्स एंड वी शुड कीप देयर स्टोरेज. देन वॉट वी विल डू, एक्सपोजर ऑफ दिस ट्राइकोग्रामा टू द होस्ट एग्स ऑन द लार्ज क्वान्टिटी विल अलाउ टू ग्रो ट्राइकोग्रामा इन साइड द होस्ट एग्स इन द लार्ज क्वान्टिटी. Then we will go for the mass production for augmentation release. Okay, then we should allow for the mass production of augmentation release. This augmentation release is done basically in different steps. So these are the rearing steps of trichogramma. Now, see, in the rearing of trichogramma, we should know that the rice moth is the main substrate for trichogramma to develop and emerge their larva. Basically, they feed on rice moth as their pure substrate. Okay, as we have discussed in all other lectures, that mass multiplication of Bavaria, Metarhizium, they depends on certain cereals and grains because they are good source of protein and starch. Okay, so rice moth production, for the steps for the rice moth production, what we have to do? We have to take sorghum, either pearl millet, maize grain, which are free from insecticides. Okay, we will take sorghum, pearl millet, maize grain, which are free from insecticides. They are coarsely milled. They are finely powdered in the thin, very small shape. Small powder, they are thin powder will make. And they are broken into 4 to 5 pieces in the milling machine. Milling machine is a machine which is used to do the powder. After that, The broken grains of either sorghum, pearl millet or maize, they are heat sterilized at 100 degrees centigrade for 1 hour. Why? In order to avoid any contamination of any insect, pest, bacteria or fungi, so it is required. So after milling of the sorghum, pearl millet or maize grain, these milled grains are sterilized at 100 degrees centigrade for 1 hour to eliminate the residual population of the stored insect already. When we will go for heat sterilization at 100 degree for 1 hour, what will happen? Those insect pests that are already stored in this cereals or maize, they will come out. So we can free these milled grains from insects. After that, what we will do? 2 kg of broken grains are then transferred to the plastic corcaira. Okay, 2 kg of broken grains are then transferred to the plastic corcaira cages. Okay, so plastic corcaira cages just is used to allow for the egg laying of trichogramma. Okay, so 2 grams of broken grains are then transferred to the plastic corcaira cages along with 5 grams of yeast. Here, what is the role of yeast? It can control or it can regulate the larval growth of corcaira, which is the substrate for the eggs of trichogramma. After mixing all the ingredients, like broken grains are transferred to the corcaira cages, we have added the yeast to control their larval growth. After mixing of all the ingredients, corcaira eggs are sprinkled on top of the mixture. Corcaira eggs are sprinkled on the top of the mixture. Okay, why? Because we can see this diagram. In this diagram, the corcaira eggs are basically found on the top of the mixture, and below there is a broken grains or mill grains. So corcaira eggs are clearly visible as they will come on the top of the mixture. Then after that, now the main focus is on how we can do the rearing of trichogramma. First of all, we can see that in picture we will take some plastic boxes. In this plastic boxes, they are having the formulation of female corcaira moths. Okay, so these female corcaira moths, they will increase their quantity. In this plastic box, we will put some egg carts so that they can lay their eggs on these egg carts. and this egg cards are placed in the rearing box. So the egg cards are placed in the plastic box, and this plastic box are kept in certain chamber. So this Corcoera moths will lay their eggs on this egg cards. So special care has to be taken when we perform this experiment for the Trichogramma cultivation. Then the ideal size of the cards should be 15 into 7.5 centimeter in size. These are the recommended size by some scientists for the rearing of Trichogramma. The cards are of 15 into 7.5 centimeter size which are used. On the size on the card, we should mention certain things. What? Like name of the laboratory, raising instructions, date of preparation of the card, and expected date of parasitoid emergence. They all should be printed on the back side of the cards, so that we should know how much time it will take for the proper rearing of the Trichogramma, in how much time they will larva will become into the adult, in how much time they will lay their eggs. So what things should be mentioned on the back side of the card? Name of the laboratory, releasing instructions, date of preparation of card, expected date of parasitoid emergence, which are printed on the back side of the cards. Then once they will lay their eggs, we will use acacia gum. Gum is used to paste something, so we'll dilute acacia gum, which is used for pasting of the eggs on the egg card. Okay, so what is the role of acacia gum? It is used for pasting the eggs on the egg card. Then this female Corcoera moths, they will lay the eggs on the egg cards. So what will happen? All of the eggs, they are pasted on the cards by the help of acacia gum. And I have told you that the size of the card should be 15 into 7.5 centimeter. The name of the laboratory should be mentioned. Releasing instructions should be mentioned. Date of preparation of card should be mentioned. And expected date of parasitoid emergence should be mentioned. Where they should be mentioned on the back side of the cards. And acacia gum is used to paste the eggs which are laid by the females on these cards. After that, once these cards are having the chambers, when the cards are having the eggs of the female Corcoera moths, we will transfer these cards into the Trichogramma chambers. Okay, we will transfer these cards which are already having lot of eggs secreted by the female Corcoera. We will transfer these cards into the Trichogramma chambers, where mated females of Trichogramma are already present. Sexually mated females of Trichogramma are already present. So this is a chamber. It contains plastic cages. In that we are having the egg cards, and the egg cards, female Corcoera moths eggs are pasted using acacia gum, and they are kept in the Trichogramma chamber for certain time. And we can expect the date of the parasitoid emergence. So all these things should be mentioned on the back side of the cards. After that, once the eggs are pasted on the egg card, and we have transferred the egg card in the Trichogramma chamber. You can see this photograph. This is the egg card. Small, there are the eggs of the Corcoera moths, which are pasted on this tricho card with the help of acacia gum. Now what we will do, the egg pasted on the cards, they are again sterilized by exposing under 30 watt UV light. Okay. Why it is required? It is required to avoid any contamination of any other insect, any other bacteria, any other fungi, any other virus, any other pest. So what we will do, the egg pasted on the cards are sterilized by exposing the cards under 30 watt UV tubes at a distance of 35 centimeter from the source of 10 minutes. Okay, so the eggs are pasted on the cards. They are sterilized by exposing the cards under 30 watt UV tube at a distance of 35 centimeter from the source of 10 minutes. The time interval should be 10 minutes. And the time and the power should be around 30 watt UV tube at a distance of 35 centimeter. After that, what we will do? The eggs on the cards are exposed to the adult Trichogramma. Okay. eggs on the cards are exposed to adult trichogramma for 24 hours at temperature of around 28 plus minus 2 degree. It can be 26, it can be 30. I mean to say that proper light condition should be there, that is 30 watt UV tube. Timing should be 10 minutes. Then the eggs on the cards are exposed to adult trichogramma for one day around 28 to 30 degree temperature in transparent plastic container. After that, what will happen? The female, mated female of trichogramma will help to parasite the eggs of Corcuera moths. So what will happen? We can see in the diagram that some small black color eggs are there. So this parasitized eggs, they will start turning black on the third day after parasitization. Okay, so this parasitized eggs start turning black on the third day after parasitization. Means initially, once they are infected with the trichogramma, they will automatically start turning black on the third day after 72 hours. And the life cycle of trichogramma is very, very short. So the complete life cycle of trichogramma is completed within 7 to 8 days. And the eggs, when they are turned black, they can be stored in the refrigerator or they can be transported for the field release. Okay, the eggs which are already parasitized with the trichogramma, they can be stored in the refrigerator and they can be transported in the field release. So what will happen? The emergence of the adults generally takes place after 3 to 6 days after blacking of the eggs. So I will repeat the whole procedure once again. What we have done? We have pasted the eggs of Corcuera moths on the egg card with the help of acacia gum. Now the egg card is having lot of Corcuera moths eggs. The eggs are kept in the trichogramma chamber where they are mated with the female trichogramma. After that, the trichocard which are having the eggs, after mating with the trichogramma, you will keep them in the 30 watt UV tube at a distance of 35 centimeter for 10 minutes. After that, these trichocards having the eggs, okay, they are exposed to adult trichogramma for 24 hours at 30 degree temperature. After that, what will happen? After 3 days, the eggs will start turning black. If the eggs start turning black, it means they are parasitized. We can see this figure. This is a trichogard. Lot of eggs are there. Their color changes into black color after 3 days. So the complete life cycle of trichogramma is completed in 7 to 8 days. Okay, and the eggs, when they are turned black, they can be stored in the refrigerator or they can be transported for the field release. The eggs, they are turned black, they can be stored in the refrigerator or they can be transported for the field release in the short period of time. Because the complete life cycle and the emergence of the egg do not take so much amount of time. So the emergence of the adult generally takes place after 3 to 6 days, just after the blackening of the eggs. It can be around 1 week also. Time can be show some variation of 1 or 2 days. So this is the whole process of rearing of trichocards. Now you see this diagram. See, this is the trichogramma wasp species. Okay, it is the adult wasp. Here, see, it is the wasp larva. From the wasp larva, it becomes the pupa. From the pupa, it becomes the emerging adult wasp and ovipositing the female wasp. So this is the host eggs. And I told you what are the host eggs: sugarcane borer, maize borer. So what will happen? When there is a whole larva, from the larva it becomes a pupa. Pupa becomes the adult, emergence of adult wasp, and finally it will form the trichogramma wasp species. Now see this diagram again. Here the female is laying eggs. Okay, parasitized eggs, they are mated with the moth eggs, and see the color of the eggs start black in color. It means they are normally parasitized with the trichogramma female mated female trichogramma. So the eggs of Corcuera, they are already mated with the female trichogramma. Okay, we can easily visualize the parasitized eggs on the trichocards. So it is a complete life cycle of trichogramma, which completes around 6 to 7 days. And after 3 to 6 days, when the eggs turn black, there is the emergence of the adult species. Though it go under different larval conditions also, it will form larva, then it will form pupa, they will multiply on the host egg, then they will form the complete adult wasp. Okay, then we discuss about how we can release the trichogramma in the field. Okay, after that we will discuss how we can release the trichogramma in the field. See, this is a trichocard. It is having the parasitized eggs of trichogramma. Parasitized eggs are there. Emergence of adult will be done. This trichocard is tied on the leaf of certain plant. Whenever the insect pest will attack on that, it will automatically paste on this trichocard and it will die because its eggs will become parasitized. So this trichogramma can enter inside the body of the insect and it can cause the parasitism in the insect only. So basically, when the release of trichogramma done, two types of approaches are there. One is inoculative and other is indentive. So inoculative and indentive augmentation approaches are applied for the release of trichogramma. Okay, inoculative and indentive augmentation approaches are applied for the release of trichogramma. So what is the difference between these two species? We will discuss that. For inoculative control, trichogramma are released at a rate of 750 to 15,000 per hectare at the 10 days interval. Okay, so in inoculative control, the dose level is around 7,500 to 15,000 per hectare at every 10 days interval. But the indentive control, in the indentive control, what we will say, the total number of trichogramma wasp release range from just about 10 times, that is about 1,50,000 to about 3 lakhs per hectare. So for indentive control, total number of trichogramma wasp release from 1,50,000 to 3,00,000 per hectare according to the field conditions, ecology and pest infestation. So these are two different types of release of trichogramma in the field. In the indentive control, basically depends upon the field conditions, whether it is so much infected, less infected, medium infected, and what is the ecology of the pest manifestation, infestation, what are the current environmental conditions. It is not the matter that any time we can release a trichogramma. We should take the very precaution of environment also, whether the time is rainy season, summer season or winter season. But the number of wasps quantity is about 10 times more as compared to inoculative control. Okay, so number is about 10 times as compared to native control of trichogramma. Then we discuss about what are the precautions which we should take for the release of trichogramma. See, in every experiment, every protocol, there are positive aspects, negative aspects and preventive measures. If we will follow the preventive measures, our task will be completed very soon. So during the release of trichogramma, what preventive measures we have to follow? First, as I mentioned, that the emergence date of parasitoid should be specified on the cards to guide the user. Name of the laboratory, date of the issue, expected date of the parasitoid, because it will help the user to basically understand about the basic time interval of trichogramma. In how much time they have to use, in how much time they have to apply. So the emergence date should be specified on the cards to guide the use. Further, the cards should be stapled on the inner side of the leaves. Okay, because if the cards should be tied on the upper side of the leaves, what will happen? Lot of insects will feed. They will sit on the cards, and due to the sunlight, what will happen? That cards which are having the eggs of mated female trichogramma, which are parasitized, they can get destroyed. So we have to take the precaution that the cards should be dyed, should be stapled on the lower side of the leaves, because it do not contain the sunlight. It is a shaded area and it can provide the prevention to the parasitized trichogramma female moths. So the card should be stapled on the inner side of the leaves to avoid the direct sunlight. Next point, the card should be stapled in the morning hours and just before emergence to avoid predation. Two things we are including that. The card should be stapled in the morning hours because During the morning hours, there is minimum temperature. When the time goes on, it comes afternoon, there is an increase in the temperature. So morning hours is the best time to staple the cards on the lower side of the leaves. Okay, and just before emergence to avoid predation. So we should know about the exact date of emersion of parasitoids so that we can protect it from the predation from the other insects. Then we should avoid the application of insecticides. Okay, then we should avoid the application of insecticide in the field where trichogramma are released. Why? Because insecticide contains certain chemicals. They may damage the larva, they may damage the eggs which are already present on the trichocards. So we should not use any kind of insecticide in the field when we are releasing the trichogramma. If need arises, we can use safer insecticide if we think that alone trichogramma is not capable to control the insect pests. Then we can use certain insecticides which are safer so that they could not damage the parasitized eggs of this. But if we are using the insecticide, we should be ensure that the insecticide which are used 15 days after or before the release of trichogramma. We should not use during the release of trichogramma. Okay, so the time interval should be either 15 days before or 15 days later during the release of trichogramma. So these are the main important precautions. What I will repeat once again, the date should be mentioned on the trichocard, the date of name of the card, name of the laboratory, expected date of emergence of parasitoid should be mentioned so that it can help the user to understand how much time it will take for the proper life cycle. The card should be stapled on the lower side of the leaves because they are protected from the sunlight. The card should be stapled during the morning hours because at that time, most of the predators are inactive and the temperature is minimum. When we know the date of emergence of parasitoid, we should protect it from the different pest control. We should avoid the application of insecticide because it can damage the eggs of the trichogramma. But we still think that the things are not in our control, then we can use certain insecticide. But we have to ensure that either we are using that insecticide 15 days before or 15 days after the release of trichogramma. Okay, so these are the key important features which we are taking precautions for the release of trichogramma. Then we can see that picture. This is the stapled trichocard in the form. These are trichogramma are released. These trichocards are stapled on the leaves. We do not spray insecticide after the release. If we will spray insecticide, the whole eggs will damage. So this is the clear picture about the trichogramma. Okay, so in this topic we understand about the basic concept of trichogramma, how we can rear the trichogramma, what are the advantages of the trichogramma, how we can make trichocards, what is the importance of trichocards, how we can, what precautions we have to take during the release of trichogramma kill noise. Okay, so these are the main preventive measures. So after that, now we have discussed about all the biocontrol agents like NPV virus, Bacillus subtilis, Pseudomonas fluorescens, Trichoderma fungi, Trichogramma parasitoids, Bavaria baciana fungi, Betaridium fungi. Now to start, now all things have been finished in the biocontrol agents. Now I will talk from the business point of view. As an entrepreneur, as a farmer, how I can start the business of this production of biocontrol agents. So this topic is very, very important. Means, what is the economic importance of biopesticide? How much cost we will include for the production of biocontrol agents, for the mass production of biopesticides? So we should know about the exact calculation, which should be kept in mind before starting the business of this biocontrol agents or biopesticides. So everything should be clear in mind. Okay, so everything should be very, very clear in the mind how we can control the economic importance or how we can start our business as an entrepreneur. So this topic is very, very important in the last. If we want to conclude about all the things which we have discussed in the lecture of biopesticides. First of all, we will discuss about the expenditure. Okay, the expenditure do not include the marketing expense. Now we will discuss about first the capital investment. The capital investment is approximately about 12 lakhs. it includes the building cost of site, because we require certain space to start the business. Then we require certain equipments and apparatus. Okay, that cost includes around 41 lakhs. Okay, so capital investment is 12 lakhs plus 41 lakhs. It makes how much? 53 lakhs. Okay, then operational cost. This cost is variable. These two things are that cost which are non-recurred means they are fixed. We have to invest only one time. Building cost, we have to invest only one time. Equipment and apparatus cost, we have to invest only one time. The total cost is around 12 lakhs and equipment cost is around 41 lakhs, because they require a lot of sophisticated equipments for the production of biocontrol agents in the laboratory. Then we discuss about operational cost. This cost is a little bit variable. So it includes first working capital, it includes raw materials like media, chemicals, fertilizers, plant material, media composition, wheat, cereal, grains. So that cost is approximately around 10 lakhs. Staff salary we can negotiate, but randomly we can consider this as around 2.04 lakhs. Okay, labor cost, we can say it is around 2.5 lakhs. Electricity cost, it is normally about 50,000, not so much cost. Traveling expense, it includes around 50,000, because we have to travel here and there for marketing point, to collect the sample, to collect the chemicals, to collect the required agents. Okay, then we require certain administrative expense. We have to keep the manager, we have to keep the advertisement cost, we have to put the HR manager, we have to put the managing the bills, expenditure, earning. It includes administrative expense, that is around 50,000. Then suppose we are taking any loan. So interest on loan and depreciation is around rupees 70,000. Okay, so the interest on loan and depreciation, that is, we can say, it is around what? It is around 70,000. Okay, some miscellaneous expenses also there, that is includes hidden cost, that is around 26,000. So this total variable cost, approximately it comes around 17 lakh. Total investment is around 70 lakh. We will add A plus B. A is equal to 53 lakh, B is equal to 17 lakh. So 53 plus 17 is equal to 70 lakh. But actual initial investment, we can start this our business from around 50 lakhs also. However, this cost do not include the marketing expense. So the actual investment cost is around 50 lakhs. We can start our business from the 50 lakh rupees. So it is a total rough, though it is not fixed, but it is rough estimate how much amount of money we can require. Now, that amount we can take loan from the NGOs, we can take from the private agencies, we can take from the different government agencies. It depends upon the collaboration between the agencies, NGO, government agencies, private agencies. It depends upon the farmer, whether the farmer is a small size farmer or intermediate farmer or large size farmer. Okay, industry either small scale, medium sized or large sized. A lot of things depends on the cost. Now, besides that, I will explain you the total detail cost of equipments that we calculated. So in the first of all, we require primarial capacity. We require in foreign quantity, their cost is 26 lakhs. We require shaker. We require two shaker. The cost is around 1.5 lakhs. We require laminar airflow, only one in quantity. This expenditure is only one time, not again and again. All experiments, we are just requiring only one time, not again and again. So laminar airflow cost, we require one, that is around 60,000. Autoclave, we require two, one for the media, one for the chemical. The cost is around 30,000. We require hot air oven. The cost is around one. We require around 10,000. Hot air oven. See, a hot air oven, incubator, refrigerator. Okay, so hot air oven, autoclave cost is How much? Around 10,000. Hot air oven, 10,000. We need one incubator, cost is 10,000. We require one refrigerator, cost is 30,000. We require certain microscope to visualize either the eggs of trichogramma, the colonies of fungi, colonies of virus, colonies of bacteria. Definitely, we require microscope, one in quantity. Its cost is around 75,000. We require pH meter, one, to know the different pH of media which we are using for the mass multiplication. The cost should be 15,000. Then we require physical balance to weigh all the chemicals, all the media components, all the nutrients. That is for 10,000. We require electronic balance because we require to measure in the macrogram level also. For that, we require electronic balance. That is how much? About 75,000. We require counterpoised balance, 5 in quantity. It includes cost of 25,000. We require sealing machine to fix something, 25,000. Work benches, around 4, they include 30,000. Plastic trays, we require around 50, that comes for around 25,000. Okay, then we require aluminium trays or zinc trays, around 10. The cost is around 20,000. Then we require only one trolley, the cost is around 10,000. Then we require automatic packing machine, one in quantity for the packing of to sell these biopesticides in the market. We require one that is around 9,000. So when we add all these chemicals and equipments, it comes around almost around 41 lakhs. So that expenditure we have to make only one in the life. Okay, that expenditure we have to make once in the life. Okay, so total cost comes around 41 lakhs. Okay, then we discuss about the working capital. The cost of mother culture is around 0.05 lakhs. Glass hair cost is around 70,000. Okay, the cost of chemical are little bit actually costly. So we can say that the cost of chemical is around basically 2.5 to 3 lakhs. Polythene bags we require in the quantity of about 3.5 lakhs because they are a little bit costly. We require carrier materials, means that certain kind of small vehicle or small machine we require. The cost of that carrier materials is around 3 lakhs. And I told you some miscellaneous items, that is hidden cost, like water supply, washroom, tables, chairs, printer, okay, rim paper, stapler, gum. So these are comes under hidden cost. That cost comes around 25,000. So that cost is around 10 lakhs. This working capital is little bit variable. It is not the matter that it can be less also, it can be more also. But the cost of equipment is fixed. It is around 41 lakhs and that investment is one time. But the investment of working capital, it is required again and again, again and again. Okay. So the cost of working capital requires again and again. Then becomes about staff salary. At least one technical staff we will give salary of 9,000, which can be negotiated, can be more or less. So when we give this salary for 1 year, it comes out to be 1,08,000. It comes to be around 1,08,000. If you acquire the laboratory staff, 2 in number, that cost comes around 4,000. 2 staff means 8,000 total cost for 1 year. It comes for around 96,000. So the total cost is around 2,04,000. Okay, so the total cost is around 2,04,000 staff salary. For this calculation is for 3 staff for 1 year. However, this cost can be negotiable. Okay, this cost is sometimes negotiable. Okay, then comes about the production capacity. If in the first year we are producing, suppose our production is 60%, then the total cost of biocontrol agents and biopesticide is about 90 million tons per year. Again, I am telling it depends upon the working efficiency of staff, about the conditions of availability of chemical, how much amount of money you've invested. We are talking this about the initial cost of 50 lakhs when you start this business of around 50 to 70 lakhs. Based on that, this calculation has been done. Okay, based on that, this calculation has been done. Okay, so if we are starting this business, suppose we can expect around 50 lakh rupees. So when we are when our industry is working with 60% efficiency, it will produce around 90 million tons per year. Okay, it will produce about 90 million tons per year. When our industry is working with 75% capacity, it comes to be 112.5 million tons per year. It is around average. It can be 89, it can be 92. I am just sharing the average value. And when we are doing the production of about 100% capacity, then it comes to be 150 million ton per year. Okay, then it comes to be around 100% capacity. Then it comes to be around 150 million ton per year. Okay, so with 60% capacity, 90 million tons per year. With 75% capacity, 112.5 million tons per year. With 100% capacity, 150 million tons per year. Okay. So actually, this is the rough estimate of the calculation. So finally, again, I will reach to the point. This comes out to be the exact calculation which we discuss. See, again, I'm telling the expenditure in block A, that is capital, means in the building and equipment, we have to do only one time. So they are called as non-recurring cost. And the other cost, that is operational, that cost is variable. It changes every year. Okay, this cost changes every year. So this cost is little bit, we can say it is about variable. Okay, so this cost is variable. Means so like average working capital 10 lakhs, staff salary 2.04, labor 250, electricity, traveling, administrative, interest on loan. See, interest on loan and depreciation, it depends upon either we are taking the loan from a government bank, from NABARD, from NGO, from private agency. It depends on them. So the total cost is around 53 lakhs of non-recurring cost, 17 lakhs, which is recurring, which is changes every year. The total cost comes out to be 70, means average 70, means 53 plus 17 comes out to be 70. And I have told the bifurcation of all the cost. So the actual initial investment cost comes around 50. Okay, so the actual initial investment cost comes around 50. So this is the exact, we can say that the cost of working capital. And I've already shared the variable cost, the instrument which we are required, like shaker, airflow, autoclave, hot air oven, incubator, refrigerator, microscope, pH. These are required in every laboratory, not in the case of biocontrol agents. These instruments are required in the all kind of scientific industry. Chilling machine, work benches, plastic trays, aluminum trays. So this is the 41 lakh cost. And finally, we discuss about the working capital, like mother culture is 0.05 lakh, 5,000, glassware, chemicals, which we can negotiate, porcelain bags, carrier materials, miscellaneous, the staff salary, we can increase or decrease upon the level of the industry. Okay, staff salary, it depends upon the level of the industry, we can increase or we can decrease. Okay, so that comes around 9,000 for one technical staff, it costs around 1,08,000. Laboratory staff, we require 2, that is 4,000 into 2 into 12,000, 96,000. This cost comes around 2,04,000. And if the production cost comes around 60% capacity, the cost is 90 million tons per year. If the production capacity is 75%, cost increase about 112.5 times per year. And if the 100% capacity is there, 150 million tons per year. Overall, we discussed that what is the actual budget we require for to start the industry of the bioresource control agents and biopesticides. Though this amount is little bit very high amount is there, but it can give you the profit just from the initial date of the business, because in the recent scenario, many scientific companies or private companies, they are hiring the technicals or scientists who are expert in their production of the biocontrol agents, and they are giving very good wages. So the demand in the market is very, very good. Okay. So the demand in the market is very, very good. We can become itself as a self-entrepreneur. Okay, we itself can become the self-entrepreneur to develop this. So these we discuss about first the importance of trichogramma, and then we discuss about the importance of the budget which we are using in the production of all kind of biocontrol agents. Okay, though there we can change the budget up to certain extent, we can negotiate. Lot of scientists, lot of companies are there from which we can negotiate. So as an entrepreneur, we can initiate this business of with rupees 50 lakhs. This was the total concept of sharing the best views of about trichogramma and the, our business, total economic importance of bio, because every concept is based on the economy. We should all, India, we know that is the agriculture country, but this agriculture is the major contributing factor of the GDP. Okay, so I hope this can understand your lecture better. So thank you very much. We discussed today about trichogramma and economic importance of biopesticides. So I hope this lecture will give has given you the better understanding of both things. Thank you very much.